Hey guys, what's up? Here I am on the California coast, and I just found a native insect of the region, and here it is. Want to learn how to fold it? Ready, set, here goes.
All right, so for this praying mantis, whose head rotates 180 degrees, I'm going to use a 6-inch square, but I recommend using a 10-inch square. Begin white side up and fold in half. We're making a square base. Unfold and repeat in this direction. Fold this corner to this point. Turn over and fold up like this. Open the big pocket, put your finger inside and push the two points together and flatten. Fold the front flap to here. And now fold these flaps up. Open and squash. And repeat. Okay, now fold this flap to the crease. And repeat. And repeat on this side. And fold this flap down and this flap down and fold this flap down. So here's what it looks like. Now fold this flap to this point. And now we're going to rabbit ear this flap. So first fold like this and fold to the crease. Unfold and fold this edge to the crease. And fold both at the same time. And unfold the rabbit ear and fold this point to here, but just fold from this point where the crease touches the edge, that point to where this crease touches the edge, like that. And now unfold and remake the rabbit ear. And fold up on that crease. So it's like that. And turn over. And now we're going to rabbit ear this side, but first fold up the flap. And unfold And now rabbit ear. Now using the flap behind, fold this up, matching like that. Okay, now fold this edge to here. Try to make sure that the layers don't slide. And turn over and repeat. Hold the layers down. Now fold this flap up. Well, actually just one flap. Fold one flap up and one flap on this side. And turn over and repeat. Fold up like this. Rotate and fold this edge up, letting the flap swing out. And fold this corner like this. Turn over and unfold. And now fold this crease, fold it to the middle. And fold this to this crease. And fold the tip like this. Rotate and fold this edge to here. So we're just like turning the page like that. And flatten. Okay, make these creases nice and sharp. And I know you're gonna hate me, but it's time to completely unfold. Yeah, we messed up. Completely messed up. We have to start all over again. Well, not exactly. But yes, we do need to completely unfold. Okay, and like I like to say, here we have a street map of your favorite city, and we have to travel on each of these streets exactly once. So let's begin on this flap right here. We're going to pleat sink this triangle. So, rabbit ear. And Now fold on this triangle. So we're pinching it right around that triangle. So it's like that. And now on this triangle. So it's like this. And turn over and pinch and push that little triangle in like that. So we just pleat-sunk that triangle. Repeat on the other side. Okay, now we're going to pleat sink on the square. So we're going to begin with this square. Pinch mountains. And next square, valleys. Like this, and continue with the next square as mountains, and so on. Okay, now this is what it looks like. Now fold this up and out and now sink here. So it's like that, and repeat. And repeat on this side. Okay, so here's what it looks like. And now we're going to start with these middle legs right here. So okay, we're going to fold them up. So we're folding. Here's the middle crease right here. We're folding diagonally like that. So it ends up with a white triangle like that. So it was like this, and we just did that. And now narrow it by pinching these two edges together. Okay, keep in mind, this is the side that will show. So try to make that side look good. This side, it doesn't really matter. And repeat. And pinch the edges together. Okay. Now, I think we should probably sink this extra little white piece. So just, we should have done this before, but just push it in. Like that. And same on this side. Okay. Now we're going to rabbit ear. And again, keep in mind, this is the side that you want to make look good. So hold the layers together, and we're just pinching it, we're narrowing it. Like that. I'm gonna just try to fix this little thing up right here. Okay. That looks better. Okay, so this side looks good. This side doesn't really matter. That's under the model. That will be under the model. Okay, and repeat on this side. and repeat on this side. Again, I'm gonna sink these. Okay, so we're just doing the same thing. So this is the side that you want to make look good. So try to keep those layers together. And repeat. Okay, so things are like this. Now we're going to open here. So we're opening this flap and opening this flap. This is going to be the tail. This is going to be the head. And we're opening it and flattening it. Careful not to rip in the center. So it's like that. Okay, so this is the head. Let's make the head. So turn over and open and squash. So it's like that. Now turn over, and we're going to fold this edge so that it is even with this line. Okay, now fold this flap up how much we want the fold to be right on this line from here to here. Okay, now let's rotate the head back and forth. Now, as you do this, just loosen this fold right here that we just made. Make it go all the way like this, all the way to here. We're just wanting that to be a loose joint. I'm going to loosen it from the other side so you see what's happening. Okay, that's nice and loose. From the top again, it can rotate. And now make a mountain fold that goes from this point to about here. We're narrowing the neck and from here to here. So it's like that, and make sure that your head still rotates. Now you might want to just stop here, but if you want to try to define eyes, then just make a little pinch there and a little pinch there. And just make little curves on the raw edges. Something like that, just to suggest that there's eyes. You don't want to make a whole bunch of pleats, otherwise it gets looking messy. Maybe like that. Okay. Now, fold, let's narrow the abdomen. So it's like this, or just folding from here to about here, just a long fold to narrow things. And this also helps tuck the ugly layers inside. And repeat. This is basically just shaping it to taste. Okay, now with these legs, let's fold them up and back down. So we're going up like this, up and down. And we can put a little bend in the middle legs. But the idea is that we want the middle legs to stick out a whole lot. So it's going to be like this. We want the tail to be touching and it to be extended out like this. If it can stand like this with these arms up, then you're in good shape. Okay, now for these ones, open and squash. So you're pinching here and pushing down like this. And so it's down like that and fold up. And fold the arm in half. So we just did a crimp. That's all we're really doing. And now do a crimp going forwards. So you pinch it, squash it forwards, and fold it in half. Like that. And repeat. And I'm going to fast forward this part. And just shape it to taste. And open up the tail. And again, you want to try to get it so that it stands up like this, so that these arms are up in the air. There it is. And it might not have feelers, but it goes left and right 180 degrees. And that's one of the cool things, is that praying mantis is the only insect that can turn its head like this. So, there you go. Alright, hope you guys were able to fold it, and see you guys later. Whoosh.
And he even joined me to watch the sunset.